Hello friends, welcome to QA tutorial series for beginners. This is lab 3. Today we are going to learn how to write simple SCF input file for Quantum Espresso for beginner levels and how to generate advanced SCF input file for Quantum Espresso using online tool advanced level. Please subscribe my channel for more videos and information. Today we will learn how to create a simple SCF file for graphite. Then we will get detailed information about it in the next lab. Let's start. First open Notepad. Then create a simple input structure. This is the simple skeleton of SCF file. The general structure consists of three main tape, control tape, system tape, and electrons tape. And has information about atoms and its arrangement. Let's save it first. By click on Save As button, first choose your destination folder, I suggest you to create a separate folder for each calculation. Here is my calculation folder for calculation is a lab 3. Write file name. Here I choose graphite. Dot in. And save as type. This is very important. Choose save as type as all file and then click on save button. Now open your destination folder. Here is a graphite file type is in file. Open graphite.in. This is control tab, which include parameters that control your calculation. First of all, we have to tell Quantum Espresso which type of calculation we want to perform here. So we write calculation. Is equal to SCF in inverted comma. Then after you have to set a path for your studio directory, a directory where your studio potential file are located or is located by studio underscore dir is equal to. Here I wrote dot. Here dot means your pseudo file is located in the same folder where your input file is located, means in current folder. I suggest you to keep a pseudo potential file and input file together in the same folder, which will be easy to transfer those files from one computer to other computer. Now this is system tab. In this system tab, it contains information related to your system, means your crystal or your materials. So for that, we need a CIF file. Here we use graphite, so we search for graphite CIF. Go to materialsproject.org site. Here you can get information about graphite system regarding latest parameters, number of atoms in this system, means in this crystal. Here a number of atom in this crystal is 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Its arrangement in the crystal and structure type. Crystal structure type is hexagonal, so now input this data in a file. So in the system tab we input I brow for Braves lattice is equal to 4. Actually for this value you should look into the Quantum Espresso documentation. So go in a Quantum Espresso official page, resources, documentation, input data description, PWSCF. Here system tab. In system tab iBrav, click on iBrav. Here is hexagonal. For hexagonal, value of iBrav is equal to 4. For cubic, I means BCC, FCC and SC, these values we can use. So for hexagonal we will write 4. So I take eyebrow is equal to 4. Now lattice parameter A is equal to, go to CIF file. Here A is equal to 2.467 angstrom. So write 2.467, I'll just copy and paste. B, A and B are same, so write C is equal to 7.803 angstrom. Copy and paste here. Okay, now number of atom in this system, NAT means number of atom, is equal to 4, because is in this crystal structure we have 4 carbon atom, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So here we write 4. Number of atom types, so N type or element type, NTYP is equal to 1, because we use only carbon here, no other atom. And then E cut WFC is equal to, here I take 25, only for this time we will take a value 25 for faster calculation. Actually this parameter is very versatile
parameter. We will learn about this parameter in a detail in our next lecture. So now on electrons tab, leave the electron tabs empty for this calculation. Here Q itself set a default values for parameters. Now enter information about atomic species. Here only one type of atom we use, and that is carbon. So enter symbol. For carbon is C. Then enter mass of carbon, which is 12.011, and then pseudo potential file. For downloading pseudo potential file, we use QE official site. Quantum espresso. Then go to pseudo potential. Then go to original QEPP table page. Here click on carbon because we want to download pseudo potential for carbon. Here is the list of different types of pseudo potentials. Here I choose this pseudo potential c.pz-vbc.upa. Right click and save link as, and save it in your current folder and click on save. Input the name of pseudo potential here. So open your current folder. Copy the name of the pseudo potential file, which is in UPF format. Paste here and write extension by .upf. Now next step is set atomic position for atoms in a crystal. So here I choose a crystal type atomic position. For this you have to go on materials project CIF file. Here is the atomic position of carbon. So copy it first and paste in your input file. Now assign each position with its atomic symbol. So here I write carbon C for carbon in each row, because we have four carbon atom and this is the arrangement of the four carbon. And separate each column by tab. Okay, now assign the value to K points. Here I choose automatic mode, and the value of K points is 444
space between each value 0 0 0. Actually, what is a key point, what is it used for, and how to get the value for that, we will see in next video. Now save this file. Now compile and run this file using pw.exe. So first open command prompt by typing cmd and go to your current directory. My current directory is in a D drive. So first change drive, then copy the link of my current directory, change to my current directory. Okay. Now type pw, then input symbol, and then your input file, output symbol, and then write name of output file by d.out out, and then press enter. Here you can see the calculation is completed. This is our output file. Click on it and go to the end of the file. Here you can see job done. Highest occupy level and total energy.